We're back with the third season of Money with Monika.
So you have your fun, but a little bit for the future. And investors in general tend to look for something called a silver bullet. But I'm going to go back to my Econ 101 and say that let's look at ourselves as a factor of production. We want this one magic product that we trust and we love, and that will solve all of our problems.
We're back with the third season of Money with Monika. We're back after almost a year, and in this past year, mutual funds have seen a huge surge in interest from people. Indian households are clearly taking interest in it as a serious investment product. Mutual fund SIPs have grown more than rupees 8,000 crore in this year. There were also a lot of regulatory changes. A lot of mutual fund houses really, you know, walked the line with their debt funds. But there is a lot to unpack here. People don't understand a lot of things about mutual funds. And in this season, we'll try to answer a lot of the questions that you have about them. Let's start with the very basics. Why do I need to invest at all? Monika, let's start by asking you, you know, there's so much to indulge in right now.
So much
fun to have.
Yeah.
Why should I postpone that?
So let me be the party pooper and say, yes, today is really important. But I'm going to go back to my Econ 101 and say that let's look at ourselves as a factor of production. Very unglamorous, but factors of production are land, labor, capital. We are labor. We can call ourselves executive director, whatever. But finally, it's labor which is generating a return. So I put in my work and there is a income which comes out of that. Now you can consume all your income today. That's fine. But we typically generate more income than we can use. So you can keep some of that for a future time when in that period, that factor of production will not generate the money that you want. For instance, when you want to do a down payment for a house or buy a car. The second is that this factor of production gets old and tired. Whether or not you want to retire, there will be a time when you're not able to go to work or you may not choose to go to work. And then, you know, how do you sustain yourself? So then you're using the excess today to target a time when this factor of production, which is labor, cannot generate an income. So you have your fun, but a little bit for the future.
Right. So, okay, clearly earning and blowing it up is not a good idea. I got it. And also just saving is not enough. Investing
Correct.
Is important. But how do we go about turning our savings into investments then?
So Indians are excellent savers, households especially. But it's when we could try to convert this S into I, the saving into investment, that we falter. Now, why do you not keep cash at home? Because of two reasons. One is that inflation causes purchasing power to fall. What does that mean? That suppose you're spending 50,000 rupees a month today, 20 years later, without you doing anything, you will need almost 1.5 lakh because of just a 5% inflation over 20 years. So that's one reason why just saving is not enough. You have to convert it into something which gives a return. And when you choose that something which gives a return, it's important to choose a product where it keeps you ahead of inflation, but also ahead of taxes. Because we function in societies, in economies where the returns on your investments are also taxed.
There are so many other things that people recommend. Say, for instance, my parents would say gold and real estate are great. I have friends who think that day trading is just the right way to make big money very quickly. So it's a great way, place to start. I understand mutual funds, but why that and nothing else?
Indian households in particular and investors in general tend to look for something called a silver bullet. We want this one magic product that we trust and we love, and that will solve all of our problems. But real life is not like that. Financial products or investments typically have to solve problems that we have. Right? And a typical household will have about 15 issues that they need to solve using finance. You can have an emergency, so you need money for an emergency fund. You need insurances. You have short, medium, long-term goals. You need to plan for retirement, right? So you need a product, or you need a product category which allows you to solve most of your problems using that one category of product. So remember, mutual fund is not a product in itself, but it's a way to invest into stocks, bonds, gold, not real estate yet in India, but abroad also real estate.
So another thing that I hear a lot, especially from my friends, is that they think that mutual funds are a stock market product, which is not true, is it?
That's right, it isn't. And that is the misconception. That's probably the way that investors have understood it, that it's a product that gives you great return. And great return usually comes from the stock market. So this is really a basic information that an investor must have before they start investing in a mutual fund, is that it's only a route to the final products. So the final products will be stocks, bonds, gold. For instance, it'll buy a bunch of stocks or bonds or invest in gold, or do combinations of this to blend products which suit a particular investor need. You're not buying a particular stock because the risk is very high for an investor, but you're using the route to buy the final products through an intermediary called the mutual fund, which constructs the products, blends them, and then puts them out for sale. So you're buying basically stocks in a box, or bonds in a box, or boxes which have combinations of these. And each of these have a particular investment objective. So every mutual fund scheme will have an objective, and you have to match your objective to that objective to get the product which suits you.
We've always grown up sort of thinking that insurance, real estate, and gold are like the three pillars. They're the investor's best friend. But is that true? Is that correct?
There are problems with only having real estate in your portfolio. It's a clunky asset. Onboarding is difficult. Maintenance has costs. The exit, especially in emergencies, has huge costs. Plus in India, there's this whole component of black money, which a lot of people, we don't want to deal with that at all. So real estate also is not a very good product to have for smaller needs. I mean, you can't sell the living room if you want just a part, if you want to liquidate a part of that investment. So you hear that 1 lakh has turned into 1 crore. But then you start asking the question, over what time? And then you look at the annual rate of return. Unless you've been really lucky, it's not that much. Gold, remember, is a hedge for inflation. It doesn't throw off any rent, interest, dividend. The only thing you do is make a profit on it. So it's great, 5 to 10% of your portfolio is okay in gold. And insurance is only for life insurance, which is a term plan. You do not bundle investments into it. They are costly, they work more for the company and the agent. They do not work for investors because they still remain opaque products. Comparing it is difficult. So you do not bundle investments with insurance. The mutual fund route allows you to invest in products which may have been very difficult for you to decode. So you have to get out of this gold, real estate, insurance mindset and move to modern financial products. And the route is through a mutual fund.
Okay. On that note of rethinking your money decisions, we have a viewer question. Riaz Ahmed writes to us. He's a 31-year-old IT professional and he has a monthly income of around 50,000 rupees. He's also paying a car loan off. He shells out around 11,000 rupees every month for the car. And he'll have to keep paying that for 2 more years. He doesn't have a retirement plan at all yet. He has the mandatory EPF. But he wants to know how to start investing in mutual funds, how he should choose them. He has a child, he wants to plan for their education and their marriage.
Riaz, 11,000 rupees car EMI on an income of 50,000 rupees. Either money is coming from your parents or there is some other story, because it's too high an EMI for a car loan on an income of 50,000 rupees. So I would really pay this loan off very quickly and then start planning my finances in a very different way. Your first product that you have to build is an emergency fund, because that's what really you need in an emergency of a job loss or a situation. So you build that 6 months of your monthly expenses you put into that, and then you start targeting your short, medium, long-term goals. It's good to have a blended portfolio. You start investing with either an index fund or a multi-cap fund, and then you blend more products as your income increases. And I think control lifestyle expenses just a bit.
I think we can all learn a little bit of that. So Riaz, I hope that answers your question and helps you plan better. That's all we have time for today, and do tune in for the next episode. In the meanwhile, if you have any questions, you can write them to us at moneywithmonika@livemint.com.
An investor education initiative by ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.